Can we start? Can you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Are you there? Yeah, good, good, good. Okay, right. Now, what was the thing that we had done in the morning, last to end with? What was the end?
Strain gauge and base sensor.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, strain gauge base sensors. Okay, now we'll just start off. So what we have discussed was the strain gauge base sensor. Now, in that case, we have discussed what was called the strain. Okay, right. In the strain gauge base sensor, the output what you are going to measure was the strain, and the input that you are going to give is either the displacement or the force. Generally, the amount of strain what you are going to measure is going to be very, very smaller. Hence, we call that those strain gauges as micro strain gauges. Okay, and generally the strain gauges are going to be of electrical type, and that's also called as resistive electrical type strain gauges. Okay, now we were discussing about the concept of the gauge factor. Okay, if I am correct. Okay, so what is gauge factor? What is gauge factor? What is gauge factor? Yeah, what is gauge factor? Yeah, Sandesh.
Yes, sir.
What is gauge factor?
The ratio between relative change in electrical resistance. To me, mechanical question.
Equation, tell me, G is equal to what? What is G is equal to?
Del R by R.
Okay.
By del L by L.
Okay, so G is the gauge factor, which is the ratio of change in resistance to original resistance by change in length to original length. Okay, right. Now here, once we understood about the gauge, what is that, strain gauges, now let us understand about the types of the strain gauges. Okay, so types of strain gauges. Now generally, we will consider the two different types of strain gauges. One is called as the foil type strain gauge. Second one is going to be called as the wire type strain gauges. Okay. Foil type is going to be something like this. Okay, so this is what is called as the foil type. Okay, which is having some surface area, right? Wire type is going to be like this. Okay, so this is going to be a wire type, and this is going to be called as foil type. Now these strain gauges, you are going to place it on the member for which you want to determine the strains. Okay, right. Now among these two, which is better is important. Okay, which is better? Any idea? Foil type or wire type? Tell me. Yatrappa, what happened? Every time you expect me to call your name, huh? Which is better? Can't you just guess and tell, okay, with the observation?
Wire type.
y wire type. If it is, if the answer is wire type, y wire type. If the answer is foil type, y foil type. I'll tell you exactly clearly. Observe. So you have the member, right? Okay. So this is what is the the cantilever beam. On this, you are going to place this type of the sensor. Okay, right. Which is the one which takes up the load? Now, if you apply, the load has to be transferred. Okay, clearly onto the member. Which is going to have more amount of area of contact? Is it the foil type is having more area of contact, or wire type is having more area of contact?
Foil type will be having more area of contact, sir.
Okay, now foil type is the one which is having more area of contact. That means from the, because what is that you are going to do? You take the strain gauge and you press it on where? Okay, you press it on what is called as the member. So therefore, whichever the strain gauge which is going to have more contact with the member will transfer all the load onto the member. Okay, so if you take a foil type, the level of contact, the surface contact is going to be larger because the foil is nothing but what? A thin sheet type. Okay, foil is nothing but a thin sheet type. But if you take a wire, in the wire, you will be having only one line contact. Are you understanding my point? Okay, in the wire, you will be having only one line which is contacting the surface strain gauge and the member. But in foil type, it is what is called as your, the paper. Okay, let's say a foil is the one which makes contact. And that too, which is going to have a larger contact. Hence, the foil type, okay, the foil type is going to be better, okay, because of more surface area. Okay, because of more surface area, the foil type is going to be better. So, among the two different cases, okay, right. Now, what are the application point of view? Okay, when we go to the application point of view, okay. Now, as I told, so this is one type of application. Okay, now what is this we are doing? Now in this case, I am using the strain gauge to determine the force. Okay, so we have what is called as a cantilever beam. I want to determine the force. Now generally, what we'll be having, we'll be having four different types of the strain gauges. Okay, we'll be having four different types of strain gauges, which forms what? Okay, which forms what are called as your R1, R2, R3, and R4. Okay, now these forums, okay, what are called as the Wheatstone bridge network. Okay, these are called as the Wheatstone bridge network. Okay, now this is basic concept of your the Wheatstone bridge. Now R1, R2, R3, R4 will be formed the Wheatstone bridge network. Okay. Now other example is going to be this is one more thing. Okay. Right. Now you have placed engage here. You have placed engage here. What is this? Can you able to guess? This is used for what? What is this setup? Any idea? If you can remember your fourth semester undergraduate. Okay, so this diagram is something which you have done. What is this? It is used for measuring the. It is used for measuring the force. Okay, so this setup is called as the proving ring. Okay, so I think you might have forgot. Okay, so this setup is called as the proving ring. Okay, now these are all the applications where you can able to use the strain gauges. Okay, and if you observe the one more example is going to be load cell. Okay, in load cell, what has happened? Okay, now this is going to be the load cell. So here is where you are going to apply the load. Okay, so here you are going to apply the load. At all this corner, okay, 1, 2, 3, and 4. In this corner, you are going to do what? These are the strain gauges, okay, right? These are the strain gauges that you are going to place, okay, right? So these are all the application of the strain gauges what you will be having, okay? So this is something related to the strain gauges, okay, right? Next, we'll go further. Next, we'll understand. Okay, right. One second. Okay. So okay, right. So next we'll go with what is called as encoder. Any idea? Anything that you know about this encoder? Yes, sir. No, quickly. Quickly, is any concept of
yes.
Okay, right. Now just observe. Okay, now these encoders are also called as the optical encoders. Okay, right. Now the purpose of encoder is mainly it's a device. Okay, used to detect the position, velocity, acceleration, and direction of rotation. Okay, just understand. I'm just writing clearly. Rotation. Okay. Okay. Right. Now, what do you mean by encoder basically? Understand, this is something called as a small device which has been attached to the rotating member. Okay, always this is attached to where? Attached to the rotating members. Okay, now when the rotating member is going to be present, I want to know what is the velocity at which it is rotating, or the acceleration at which it is rotating, whether it is rotating in clockwise direction or whether rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. In order to know that, okay, I am going to place encoder onto the device. Okay, generally what is going to happen, many of the rotating devices can't be seen through the naked eyes for you. Okay, I mean you can't observe that, because what is going to happen is there might be a possibility that the rotating members are going to be somewhere hidden, okay, somewhere within the mechanical components. Okay, therefore, in order to know that, I am going to place what is called as an encoder. Okay. Now, in this encoder, we are going to have two different types of encoders are going to be there. Okay. So we have what is called as the incremental encoder. Okay. One is called as the incremental encoder. Other one is called as absolute encoder. Okay. Second one is called as absolute encoder. Okay, right. Now we'll discuss one by one now. Okay, so we'll try to understand what is incremental encoder. Okay, right. Just observe this diagram, and just write this diagram for your reference. Okay, it's going to be useful. Note down, I will explain everything, don't worry. Thank you. Okay, should I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right, now observe, carefully just observe. Now, what is the diagram that I have drawn is the incremental encoder. Okay, first of all, encoder is nothing but a device, okay, which is going to be used, okay, which is going to be fixed onto, okay, which is going to be fixed onto any rotating member, first thing, okay. So now here, if you observe, the shaft is rotating. To this shaft, I have placed what is called as the encoder. Okay, now this is the rotating disc, rotating shaft. Are you understanding? This is the rotating shaft. To this rotating shaft, okay, I have placed what is called as the incremental encoder. Okay, what the incremental encoder is going to consist of, the very, very important, okay, the incremental encoder, the important component of the incremental encoder is the patterned disk. Okay, so this is called as an incremental encoder main element, which is a patterned disk. Okay, now in this patterned disk, there are going to be what are going to be called as the track. Okay, now what is this that I have drawn here is, these are called as the holes, equispaced holes, which are present in the track. Okay, please understand carefully. We have equispaced hole present in the track. Okay, right. Now, what is that you need to understand here is, now I draw one more view of it. So this is the track which is rotating. This is going to what? This is going to rotate along with the shaft. Okay. On one side of the track, you have LED. LED is what? LED is the photo source. LED is the photo source. On the other side, you are having photo detector. Okay. Right. Now, what is going to happen is, now a circular pattern is going to be present. So light emitting diode is used as a light source, which provides continuous light signal. Please understand. Okay. LED is the photo source, which gives a continuous light signal. On the other side, you have a photo detector, or it's also called the photo transistor, which is called as a photo light detector. Okay. Now, what is going to happen when this photo detector detects the light? When this photo detector detects the light,
there is no object.
When there is no object. Now here, what is this? Now, you just assume this is your circular pattern, correct? Huh? Are you understanding carefully? So we have what is called a circular track or a circular pattern. Okay, or you can also call it as the disk. Disk is also called as the track. Okay. In this track, what I am having? I am having what? The equispaced holes which are going to be there. Okay, how many number of holes are present now? 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Okay, 3, 5, 8. Okay. So how many number of the possibility of the light passed in one rotation? Just let me start from here. Okay, right. Right. Now just observe. When it rotates, the LED, the light is going to pass through. Correct? Huh? What is this? If this is going to be the hole, right? If the light passes through the transparent segment, are you understanding? If the light passes through the transparent segment of the track, photo detector, will it receive the light or will it not receive the light?
Receives.
Right. Okay, that try to understand. The track is rotating. Are you getting my point? Shaft is there. Shaft is anyhow it is rotating. To that shaft, I have placed the optical encoder which is circular. In that circular pattern, we have made certain slots. 8 number of slots we have made. So on the left of the track, you have photo source LED. On the right of the track, you are having photo detector. Okay. Now, photo source, that is your LED, will keep on emitting the light. Correct? Huh? Right. Photo detector, when the photo detector receives the light, whenever the light passes through the transparent segment. Are you understanding? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, whenever, now just observe, this is going to be your what? If I am going to assume this is the time, Okay, this is the output of the detector, output of the photo detector. Okay, right. Now, when there is going to be a signal, when are you going to get the signal? When the light passes through this segment. Are you understanding? I am writing again. When the light passes through this segment, I am going to get one signal. Okay, right. Then again, it starts to rotate, right? Okay, now it passes, the light passes through this portion. When it passes through this portion, will there is any signal for the photo detector?
No, sir.
No. Okay, then it passes. The time elapses. Again, when this is going to come, okay, when the rotation is going to happen, okay, when it rotates, when this is going to come, again, there is going to be what? There is going to be a signal. Okay, what is going to happen? The signals are going to be get incremented. Okay, that means now when the disk rotated, a pulsed output is going to be present. So pulsed output number one. Now this is pulsed output number two. It means what does it mean? What does it mean? What is the angular position at this point? Now this is zero. Then I will have how many number of angular displacement can be measured by here? Totally. How many number of angular displacement can be measured here?
Once.
No. This is zero. Then 360. One rotation is how much? Yeah. One rotation is how much?
360.
Correct. Huh? How many number of slots are there?
Eight.
Okay. So how many? What is the individual degree now? How much it is? 45 degree. That means photo detector will receive the light for every how much? For every
45 degrees.
That means to start with it is zero. Then for 45 degree I am going to get one reading. Then again this comes, then this will be here. Are you understanding what I am telling?
Yes
or no? So if we call this as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. First it rotates as clockwise rotation. Okay. One comes. Then you are going to get a signal from one. Okay. Then this will come. This fellow will come here. Okay. Then two. Then three. Okay. Now this, what is this happening now? 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. What is happening here? Okay. The number of pulses are going to be get incremented. Okay. Increment is nothing but what? Increment is nothing but go to the next number. Okay. So it gets added up. The number of pulses are going to get added up. Okay. Now, this, how many number of pulses, what it indicates? The number of pulses indicates what? Number of pulse indicates what?
Rotation of the
shutter. Rotation. Okay. It's simple. Okay. The number of pulses is proportional to the angle through which it has rotated. That means 1 means 0 degree. If it has come 2 means what? If it has come 2 means it has rotated by 45 degree. If it has come 3, it means rotated by 90 degree. Then 135 degree. Are you understanding? Okay. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Now, hence what is going to happen? The total number of shaft rotation can be determined by how many number of pulses produced by the datum position. Now, from here, how many number here? One rotation. Okay. One pulse. Correct or what? So one pulse means the angle that is going to be is 45 like that. Okay. The number of pulses indicates how many number of rotations which is going to be present. Okay. Now this is the basic understanding of what is called as your the incremental encoder. Okay. Now in case of incremental encoder, figure, just I'll explain again. Now this illustrates what is called as a schematic diagram of the incremental encoder. The main element of the incremental encoder is what is called as the pattern disk. Now, this pattern disk consists of equally spaced the transparent segment and the opaque segment. Okay, equally spaced transparent segment and the opaque segment. On the left side of the track, we have LED. On the right side of the track, we have photo detector. So LED is the photo source, light emitting device. Photo detector is the light receiving device. Okay, light receiving device. Now, the light is going to pass us through and the light will be detected by the photo detector when light passes through the transparent segment. when it passes through the opaque segment, it will not go into receive. Therefore, the slots indicates how many number of angular displacement you can able to determine. Okay, therefore, if you have, what is the resolution of this? What is the minimum angle that you can able to measure? By using this diagram, what is the minimum angle that you can able to measure?
45 degrees, sir.
You can measure only minimum 45 degrees. Okay, below that you can't measure. Therefore, how can you increase the resolution of this encoder?
By making more number of slots.
Simple. Okay, by making more and more number of slots, you can get that many number of angular displacement. Okay, now you got the angular displacement now. Okay, that is theta you have got. Okay, now once you got angular displacement, how can you measure the velocity? Now I told in the beginning, okay, it's a device used to detect the position, velocity and acceleration and direction. Okay, so direction is known, position is known to me, that means it is at 45 degree, 90 degree, 135 degree, 180 degree or 180 plus 45, 225 degree, like that I can say. Now I know the angular displacement, means from here how many angles it has gone. I know the angular displacement. How to measure the velocity? Hey, come on. If I know that, I want to measure the velocity, yeah.
We dividing with time.
I know the, okay, let me come to, this is angular displacement, correct? This is angular displacement, okay? I'll come to linear displacement. If you have that much doubt or confusion, linear displacement is what? X, okay? Correct. Are you understanding? How to determine velocity?
X by T.
Not X by T. It is not X by T. It is dx by dt. Okay. It is the change of rate of change of distance with respect to the time is called as velocity. How to determine acceleration? It is
d square x by dt square.
Okay, so this is for the angle linear displacement. But are we measuring linear displacement here?
No.
Okay, we are measuring angular displacement. Okay, angular displacement is theta. Theta is the angular displacement. So okay, therefore d theta by dt is your angular velocity. Okay, d theta by dt is called as the angular velocity. Okay, right. Now angular acceleration is
d square theta by dt square.
Okay, now the first derivative of the displacement is called as velocity. Second derivative of the displacement is called as acceleration. As simple as that. Therefore, if you just know the displacement, whether it is linear or angular, correspondingly you can able to measure the angular displacement, sorry, angular velocity or the angular acceleration. Okay, so that is about the optical encoder. Under that, what is called as the incremental encoder. Okay, then there is one more thing called as the absolute encoder. Okay, just we'll go further. Okay, we'll go with what is called as absolute encoder. Okay, right. Now just observe this diagram. Okay, note down this diagram. I want you to note down this diagram. Okay, I want some answer from your side. Okay, four tracks you write first. 2, 3. Four tracks you write and divided by 45 degree. Okay, divided by 45 degree. Okay, right. Now this is my track 3. This is my track 2. This is my track 1. Okay, right. Now, how many sectors you are going to get? How many sectors?
3 sir.
Hey. How many sectors here? Yeah, totally.
8 sir.
8 sectors. Okay, you will be having 8 different sectors. Okay. Right. Okay. Now, you write one more table. You write. I will tell you sector. Track 1. Track 2. Track 3. Angle. Okay. Sectors are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Write this, I'll explain. Okay. Right. Okay, right. Now just observe. Now we'll move on to what is called as the optical encoder. Okay, now this passes through. Okay. Yes. Okay, right. Now, absolute encoders are the devices which are used for the measurement of angular displacement directly. Okay. Now, the output of the absolute encoder is a binary number. Please understand this very carefully. Output of the absolute encoder is a binary number with certain number of digits. The number of digits of the binary depends upon how many number of tracks are going to be present. Okay, right. That means now binary is going to be expressed as 2 to the power of n, correct? Where n is the number of tracks. Now, how many tracks we will be having now? We are having number of tracks is equal to 3. So, how many positions you are going to get? You are going to get 8 different positions. Okay, you are going to get 8 different positions. Okay. Now, if there are 3 number of tracks, okay, right? We are going to get 8 different number of positions. Now, the principle of operation is, I'll explain. The principle of operation is that the absolute encoder will give a unique output. Okay, will give a unique output for every position. Okay, will give a unique output for every position. Now, again, the code, the disk consists of what? The disk consists of, observe, the disk consists of the transparent segment and the opaque segment. The disk consists of the transparent segment and the opaque segment. And these are going to be called as, what are called as the tracks. So there are 3 different tracks are going to be there. Now, in each of the track, you will be having the opaque segment and the transparent segment. Now we'll come back. Okay, right. Now I will consider this. Now just observe. Now this is the first track. Now this is my first track, first sector. Whatever I am drawing now is the first sector. Now just observe. This is my first sector. Right. Now the light will not going to pass here. Light will not pass here. These are all 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Are you understanding? 1. Okay. 2. And 3, I am just marking. All these are going to be opaque. Okay, if it is opaque, okay, or let us say sector 0. This is my sector 0. This is my sector 0. Okay, right. Track 1 is going to be opaque. If it is opaque, is it going to be, are you getting the signal or are you not going to get the signal? Means to the left of this again, you have LED. On the right, you are going to have photo detector. Are you understanding? To the left, you are going to have LED. On the right, you are going to have photo detector. Okay, right. Now, in this case, it is off. It is off. It is off. What do you mean by off, off, off? What is the meaning of off here? It means?
No signal, sir.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, it means photo detector will not receive the signal. Okay, right. Now, I'll come to the second one. Okay, what are the options now you are having? Okay. If there are 8 positions, what are the unique numbers you are going to get for the 3 binary? Okay, what are the numbers you are going to get? So we'll be having 0, 0, 0, correct? 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1. Is this clear to you? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
These are the possibilities of the numbers if it is going to be three digits. So 0 0 0 means what? What does it, what is the meaning of 0 0 0? Off and off means what? All of them are going to be which type? Transparent or opaque?
Opaque, sir.
Opaque. All of them are going to be opaque. Okay, right. Now, next is sector number 1 is what? 0, 0, 1. First track is 0. Second track is 0. Third track is 1. Okay. I will add if it is going to be transparent. Are you understanding?
Yes,
sir. Okay. For the first one, from where to where you are going to measure, it starts from here. It starts from here. Okay. It goes to this. What is this angle?
45 degrees.
Now, if it is sector 1, what is the angle that you can measure? 0 to 45 degrees. Yes or no?
So.
Right. Then you tell me for the sector 1. Now you tell me sector 1 is what? Track 1 is? Off.
Off.
Then? Off. Then?
Off.
On.
On.
On. Okay, right. What is the amount of degree?
45 to 90.
Then next track. Okay, next track. So 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Second one is what? 0, 1, 0. Okay. First track is 0. Second one is 1. Clear?
Yes, 0 sir. Means
off. Then on. Then off. So it is 90 degrees to 135 degrees. Correct? Okay. Right. Then 3 is what? Tell me. 3 is?
Off, on,
okay.
And on.
Off, on, and on. Okay. So now 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Right. So 3 is off, on, and also on. Okay. Then fourth one is 135 degrees to
180 degrees.
Okay. Fourth one is what now? Fourth one is
on, off, on.
Okay. On. On means? Okay. On. Next is off, off.
Off.
So this is 180 degrees to? Tell me. 225. Okay. Fifth one is what? Fifth one is 101. One is on. Next is off. Another is on. Okay. Okay. Right. It is 225 to 270. Sixth one is what? 110. One is on. Second one is on. Third one is off. So, first one is hatch. Okay. Second one is also hatching. Third one is none. Zero. This is 270 to 350 degrees. Okay. Right. Then seventh one is what?
On.
Okay. So, this is seventh one. Hatching. One more hatching. And one more hatching. Are you understanding? Right. On. Okay. It is 315 degrees to 360 degree. Now, is any chance by which these numbers are going to repeat? If I am going to have 8 number of sector, is there any chance by which numbers are going to repeat for one rotation? For one rotation, is it possible that it is going to repeat? These binary numbers are going to repeat?
No, sir.
No chance at all. Okay, binary numbers will not going to be repeated. Okay. Now, what I mean to say here is, in case of absolute encoder, you are going to get the output which are unique. Okay, these outputs are going to be unique. Okay, these outputs are going to be unique. Okay, depending upon the number of sector. Now, if you make one more track, Okay, make one more track. Okay, so if it is, let's say that four tracks. Okay, if it is four tracks, how many positions you can able to detect? Now three tracks, you could able to detect 8 positions. If you go with four tracks, how many 2 to the power of 4 is how much?
32. 16.
Okay. 2 to the power of 5 is 32. Means more the number of tracks. Okay. So three tracks, 8 position. 4 tracks, 16 position. 5 tracks, 32 position. Like that. Means more number of tracks if you are going to make, you can able to determine more number of position. This means what is going to happen? This angle is going to be reduced. Are you understanding? If it is 8, it is 360 by 8. Are you understanding? Yes or no? You can detect every
5. Yes,
okay. Then if it is going to be 16, 360 by 16. So 360 by 32, like this. The number of positions is going to be keeps on reducing. Means to say, if you want to detect smaller angular displacement, answer is what? You should have
more number of sectors.
Simple. Okay. If you want to detect smaller amount of angular displacement, you should suppose to have more number of
sectors.
Okay. So more number of sectors is possible by having more number of tracks. Okay. So more number of tracks gives you more number of sectors. That means three tracks will give you 8 sector. That means 8 positions. Four tracks will give you 16 number of sector. That means 16 positions. 5 number of tracks will give you 32 positions. Okay, that means 360 divided by 32. That much number of amount of angle you can able to determine straight away. Okay, right. So this is about what is called as the absolute encoder. Okay, right. So now think we'll stop today. Okay, right. Now the things what we have discussed is what is called as the strain gauges. We have discussed about the strain gauges. What are the different types of strain gauges and the foil type and that of the wire type strain gauges. Which strain gauge is better, that we have discussed, because depending upon the pattern, okay, depending upon what is called as the amount of contact. Then we have come up with the concept of encoder. Mainly the encoders are the devices used for the measurement of the angular displacement. So two types of encoders are going to be present. Okay, one was called as your the optical encoder. So this was the optical encoder, which is on your screen, mainly used to determine the position, velocity and acceleration, right? Number one is incremental encoder, consists of the circular pattern with the transparent and opaque segment. And on either side of the circular pattern, we will be having a light emitting diode, light source and a photo detector. Okay, right. You are going to the photo detector will receive the light only when the light passes through the transparent segment. So every time when the light passes the transparent segment, you are going to get the pulse. So when there is a pulse, it indicates that the light has gone through the transparent segment. Therefore, how many number of pulses you are going to get, that directly indicates how many number of the angular rotations that you have made. Okay. So if you know the angular displacement, then take a derivative, first derivative, you are going to get angular velocity. Take one more derivative from the angular velocity, you will get angular acceleration. Okay. So that's about the incremental encoder. Okay. Then going further, you understood what is called as the absolute encoder. So this is the one. So in this case, you are going to get the exact position. So you will be dividing the tracks into the as many number of the circular pattern into number of tracks. So more number of tracks gives you more number of position, but the output what you are going to obtain is a binary number. Okay, binary number equal to the number of tracks. Okay, now here the digits is going to be 3 digits. So 2 to the power of 3. Okay, 2 to the power of n is the number of tracks. Okay, where n is the number of tracks. So you are going to get 8 different positions. Okay, so if you want to have a larger resolution, okay, so generally you can have 16 to 32. Okay, that is the maximum that you can have. Okay, so more number of tracks that can be made, so that you can measure smaller and smaller angular displacements. Okay, right. So I think we stop at this stage. Okay, and tomorrow we'll try to understand some other types of the the sensors. Okay, continuing further. Okay, right. So, anything is there?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay. Right. Anything present?
No,
sir. Oh, right. Okay. So, if nothing is there, we'll close the class. Okay. So we'll meet on the next class tomorrow. Okay, great. Thank you. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you. Bye, sir. Bye.